In 2012, America's on-again, off-again love affair with Formula One finally seemed to settle down with the completion of this wonderful racing facility here in Texas. Since then, we've been treated to some incredible races, including, of course, that classic wet-dry championship decider of 2015. We're racing today, then, in Travis County, Texas, where 20 corners and speeds of up to 200 miles an hour await us on this magnificent racetrack. It's 60% full throttle with plenty of good opportunities to pass, especially through the two DRS zones into Turn 1 and at the end of the long back straight into Turn 12. What a race we have in store today. I, for one, can't wait to get started. And there's another very excited little chap here beside me as well. It's our very own Anthony Davidson. Great to see you again today.
Thanks for that, Crofty. And I'm really anxious to get underway here. We've got all the makings of a great race today. World champions in competitive cars, lots of drivers on form, and I suspect a few strategists on the pit wall looking to try something a bit different and maybe jump their cars up the order.
You've done well to put it on pole, but we've still got work to do. Trying to cover the inside line off the start.
Well then, after an exciting qualifying session yesterday, let's take a look at how the cars line up. It's Red Bull in pole position then, and Nico Rosberg completes the front row. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Hamilton, Button, Fernando Alonso, and Ricciardo, Grosjean, Bottas, Raikkonen, and Sebastian Vettel, Massa, Perez, Pascal Wehrlein, and Gutierrez, Hülkenberg, Harry Anto, Carlos Sainz, and Daniel Kvyat, Palmer, and Magnussen, Marcus Ericsson, and Felipe Nasser starts from the back of the grid. Now it's almost time to lights out, so let's go down to the track.
Right, let's get the car up to temperature on this lap. We're learning the gears, so go through them all if you can.
sprints begin, and well-earned they are indeed. It may have looked simple at times, but as any racing driver will tell you, competing at this level, at the very top, is anything but simple. There's no catching them now then. We have a new World Drivers' Champion. Brilliant stuff from Red Bull today. What a superb victory. Anthony, what do you think made the difference here?
It was a question of right place, right time today. We were looking at an entirely different race before the safety car came out, but they were able to take full advantage after the field had been bunched up.
So here come our winning drivers today, and what a race it was. There's been a big push at the factory lately to get these cars ready, and we can see the fruits of that labour today as Red Bull lift the winner's trophy. And now let's take a look at the driver standings. This also means that there's no catching our leader anymore, and we crown a new World Drivers' Champion. Now then, Anthony Davidson, who was your driver of the day?
I'm going to go for Marcus Ericsson. He's clearly got a very delicate touch in close proximity to other cars, and he's matured a lot over the past few seasons, which served him well today.
On to the constructors then. We saw a dip in form from the championship leaders today. Their lead has taken a significant blow. After all that excitement, it's time for a lie down, I think. Thanks for joining us, and goodbye until the next race. And after this round of the World Championship, here's how things look in the drivers' table. A strong race then for our championship leader. That's extended their advantage at the top of the standings. And now I'd like to ask you, Anthony Davidson, who was your driver of the day?
Oh, maybe Marcus Ericsson? Yes, I think I'll commit to that one. Marcus Ericsson, fine job, very consistent.
And here's how things are shaping up in the Constructors' Championship. It was a tough race for our championship leaders, who lose ground at the top of the table. That's it for today's Grand Prix, and from Ant and I, it's goodbye, and see you again next time.